Japan is shrinking, literally. Inside the Pacific Island nation, more people are dying than being born.
I'm scared for the future of my children and my country.
A demographic time bomb has already exploded, threatening to cripple the world's third largest economy.
The problem is that young women are not having enough children to keep our country going.
Japan's population has shrunk by a record 1 million since 2008. At the same time, the Japanese are living longer. Japan is home to the fastest aging society in the entire world. There are approximately 33 million people over the age of 65. That's roughly 25% of the country. And experts warn that number could reach as high as 40%.
We're dealing with an unprecedented situation. No other country in the world is facing such a crisis.
Ruichi Kaneko is head statistician at Japan's National Institute of Population. He says if the situation doesn't change, and change dramatically, Japan's population will drop from 127 million today to 107 million in 2040, 87 million by 2060, and a mere 46 million by 2100.
And the rate of aging in Japan will only climb. We're projecting that by 2060, 40% of the population will be 65 years or older.
The government is in a panic. 10 years ago, it created an agency to encourage couples to have more children.
Having a family is a beautiful thing. I'm trying to encourage others to see it as a blessing and not a curse.
But a study this year shows that Japanese just aren't interested in sex or marriage. A record 50% of married couples said they've stopped having sex. Among the main reasons, 21% of men said they were too tired after work. 23% of women said sex was bothersome.
This is why Japan is known in the world as the country with very few children.
Kaneko also discovered that millions of Japanese aren't even dating. A survey he did in 2011 found 61% of unmarried men and 49% of women in their 20s and 30s were not in any kind of romantic relationship.
And if they are in a relationship, they're postponing marriage to much later in life or simply choosing to remain unmarried.
A sentiment shared with CBN News by several young folks on the streets of Tokyo.
There are more women working today than ever before, and that's good, since it will help with Japan's shrinking labor force. But this also means that women are delaying or choosing not to get married.
Life in the city is very expensive. Trying to start a family or having children will make it even more challenging.
The strain of falling birth rates, a shrinking labor force, and longer lifespans is evident at this Christian nursing home west of Tokyo. Director Satoru Gasha doesn't have the staff to care for the elderly. He must rely on church volunteers, many of whom, by the way, are over 65 themselves.
A shrinking workforce means we have older people looking after the very old. This crisis is putting a lot of pressure on the government and society to care for the aging.
In the next 25 years, experts say half of Japan's towns and small cities could lose many of their young people, especially women in their 20s and 30s, as they flee to big cities, leaving retirees behind. Tazio Marimoto already feels the impact.
There's not many children coming to church school anymore. And then only seniors means the church will have to close someday because won't be enough people to support the church anymore.
Morimoto pastors a small church on the outskirts of Tokyo. The majority of those who attend are over 70 years old, like the Takedas, who've been married for 52 years.
Young people work so hard, they don't have time to socialize or start a family. We are praying that this changes.
Morimoto and other area pastors encourage young people to move to town.
Our local pastors here have a vision to create more Christian homes in this community, so they're providing a matchmaking between churches to provide, encourage young people to get married, have a Christian homes.
This is Sugamo, a community just north of Tokyo. It's indicative of many communities all across Japan, where the majority of the folks who live in these communities are over the age of 65. While some experts say the solution to Japan's grain problem are robots and foreign immigration.
Leading the charge is 68-year-old Atsuto Sawakami, who runs a popular mutual fund in Tokyo.
A robot bear for elderly care.
He's investing millions of dollars in companies developing robots to assist the elderly.
I'm interested in robotic suit technology that the elderly can wear to help them move around, plus other innovations that will help offset our shrinking labor force.
Sawakami is also calling for large-scale foreign immigration, or else he says Japan will face an economic collapse. But the idea of opening the country up to foreigners is not a popular one.
I'm not against foreigners, but this is a Japanese problem, and we need to solve it.
And Japan, by the way, isn't the only society getting old fast. Moody's Investor Service says in the next 5 years, 13 countries, including France and Sweden, will be super-aged, with 20% of the population over 65. The United States will reach that milestone by 2030, along with 34 other countries. Right now, Japan leads the pack. And Kaneko says if trends don't change and the country cannot quickly find solutions, the consequences will be devastating.
The impact of our rapidly aging society will affect every area of our country.
George Thomas, CBN News, Tokyo.